again.
All right, good morning, everyone. Y'all happy? Smile at me. It's good to see Cyrus here this morning and his mom and dad too. Hallelujah. Good to see all of you. Good to see CJ Tilka here today. Amen. Hallelujah. And it's good to have all of you in divine presence. God's ordered it for you to be here today. Aren't you glad for that? If you're a visitor here this morning, welcome. You're a visitor one time. If you come the second time, I'm sorry, but we adopt you and you'll be part of our family, right? Amen. And we are known as the Granola Christians. It's all the fruits, nuts, and flakes. So happy day for you. Yeah, stand if you would. We're going to pray. Y'all need coffee stat, I think, today, huh?
I don't.
What's up with that? You guys are too quiet today. Now, during worship, I want you to sing, all right? I want you to sing, okay? Now, you know, I don't know what churches you've been to before. I was raised Lutheran. We were very quiet. But you don't have to be quiet in here today, okay?
Amen.
You can raise the roof, raise a ruckus, have some fun, dance and sing, and enjoy yourself in the Lord. Amen?
Woo!
Okay. I'm hoping y'all wake up before too much longer, though. Got one scripture I want to read to you this morning before we worship. Are you ready to worship? Got to prepare your heart to worship God this morning. Amen?
Amen.
Are you thankful?
Yes.
Man, I'll tell you, this Thanksgiving, I just counted millions of blessings. There's so many to share, so many to have. And, you know, we were praying for unity up here this morning. And I'll tell you what, if you're thankful, you'll be in unity.
Amen.
Thankfulness creates a spirit of unity. Did you know that?
Amen.
A spirit in you when you're thankful of awesome praise and thanksgiving that causes you to have a different kind of attitude. That attitude of gratitude. You need that. Amen?
Yes.
Okay. Come out there and shake a few of y'all awake here. This is out of Isaiah chapter 44. It's been a blessing the last week because Douglas was going to come and minister, so I get a chance to kind of freelance in the Bible a little bit. So I've been reading a lot of different things, and this is something the Lord gave me last night. And this is Isaiah 44, verse 3. I will pour water on him who is thirsty. I don't know about you, but I'm thirsty for God today. I don't want to play religious games. I'm not interested in acting the part. You know what I'm saying?
Amen.
But being transparent and really letting God move and pour his water of his spirit into my life. How about you?
Amen.
That makes all the difference, right? You can have programs and you can have all kinds of stuff, but without the Spirit of the Most High God, we got nothing. Right. So we need the Holy Spirit today. We need to be poured into by that Spirit, that water on him who is thirsty, and floods on the dry ground. I will pour my spirit on your descendants and my blessings on your offspring. We are descendants and offsprings of the Most High God.
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen.
Say this with me. I am
a child
of the Most High God.
Amen.
Amen. That settles it. It's amen, right? So this morning as you worship, see yourself as an empty cup and let God pour his spirit into your life this morning. Amen? Be open to that. You ready?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
No, are you ready?
Yes.
All right. Grab the hand of the person next to you. We're going to pray. Woo-hoo! I'm telling you, I'm going to get me a couple of pom-poms up here eventually. Come on, church. Time to worship. That's very disturbing. Hopefully it disturbs you right into praising and worshiping. You could say, thank God I'm not like that guy. All right, bow your heads. Father, we thank you this morning for your holy presence. Holy Spirit, we just take this time to say thank you to you and give you praise and honor. Pour out of your spirit upon these thirsty vessels this morning, God, these empty vessels. Fill us with your presence. Fill us, O God, we pray thee this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you and praise you, Holy Spirit, that you're going to have your way. And everybody said amen.
Amen.
All right, greet two people and tell them you love them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Desire, and all I bring to life
to a shattered humanity. Death now overcome, forgiven all in one. You've redeemed all humanity. With all the lives we now stand, declaring loud that Jesus is God who saves. Sing loud, commission my soul with the fire, uncontrollable for this great cause, to save the lost. Open my eyes to the reason I'm alive, oh Lord, I'm ready now to follow you. Follow you now. Abandon all to be your voice, your hands, your feet. My life a living sacrifice. Spirit, empower me to set the captives free. My life is an offering. With all the lives we now stand, declaring loud that Jesus is God who saves. Sing loud, in my soul with the fire, uncontrollable for this great cause, save the lost. Open my eyes to the reason I'm alive, oh Lord, I'm ready now, follow you. Commission my soul with the fire, uncontrollable for this great cause, save the lost. Open my eyes to the reason I'm alive, oh Lord, I'm ready now, follow you. Commission my soul with the fire, uncontrollable for this great cause, save the lost. Open my eyes to the reason I'm alive, oh Lord, I'm ready now.
Hallelujah.
Follow you. Commission my soul with the fire, uncontrollable for this great cause, save the lost. Open my eyes to the reason I'm alive, oh Lord, I'm ready now to follow you. Commission my soul with the fire, uncontrollable for this great cause, save the lost. Open my eyes to the reason I'm alive, oh Lord, I'm ready now, follow you. Follow you.
Have your way, oh God.
Open the heavens wide. pour out your spirit on us.
Thank you, Jesus.
Open the heavens wide.
Yes, Lord.
Open the heavens wide. Oh, 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 I open the heavens wide. Pour out your spirit on us. Open the heavens wide. Open the heavens wide. Oh, oh, oh,
bless you,
man. Open the heavens wide. Pour out your spirit on earth. Yeah. Open the heavens wide.
Yes, Lord God.
Open the heavens wide. Pour out your spirit on us.
Pour your spirit on us, Lord. Amen.
Open the heavens wide. Open the heavens wide. Open the heavens wide. Pour out your spirit.
Spirit on us, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, we give you praise, oh God. Hallelujah. Pour your spirit on us this morning, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Father. Need that Spirit of God this morning. Amen.
We waited for this day. We gathered in your name. We're calling out to you.
Your glory like fire.
Awakening desire will burn.
That's right.
Show us your power.
Show us your glory, Lord.
Oh, yeah.
the floodgates.
The mighty river flowing from your heart, oh, peeling every part of our frame. When things say, open up the heavens.
Yeah.
We want to see you.
Ah, church,
open
sing it out.
The floodgates. A mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our frame.
Hallelujah.
Thanks.
Woo! Hallelujah. Amen. I know about you. I'm having fun this morning. You having fun? Yeah. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit is here. Hallelujah. Like a floodgate. Amen. Hallelujah. And a one. And a two. Thank you, Jesus. I would choose you this morning.
I have searched to find the meaning of this life. Something that would fill my empty soul. Some believe a lie, choose darkness over light. But I will stand and let the whole world know. I choose Jesus, I choose Jesus, the one who I've seen the cross and I believe His choice comes at a cost. All other things are lost. No other love can mean so much to me. I choose Jesus, I choose Jesus, the one who first chose me.
Amen.
I choose Jesus, for now and eternity.
Amen.
He chose to love me when I felt unlovable. He chose to reach me when I felt unreachable. He carried me out of my fear and doubt. How I want the world to know. I choose Jesus. I choose Jesus. I choose Jesus. The one who first chose me.
Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God, we give you praise. Oh, take a minute. Just lift your hands and give him thanks and praise this morning that he's chosen you. Brought you out of darkness into the light. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Hallelujah. We give you praise, thanksgiving, oh God. You are wonderful. Faithful are you, O God. Oh, you are faithful to us, O God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord. Praise your holy name. Hallelujah. Oh, we praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord God, you are wonderful. We give you praise, oh Lord.
Bless your people, O God. Hallelujah. Wow. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Bless you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Praise God. Aren't you glad God's a covenant God? He never breaks his covenant with you. You might mess up, but guess what? God doesn't. If you find yourself away from him today, guess who moved? It weren't him. It were you. So you can move right back into his grace. Amen?
Amen.
And you can experience everything he is this morning. There's nothing holding you back. Somebody said, well, I got sin sometimes. You know, hey, remember that thing on the cross there? Jesus took your sin. You got a free lane, man, all the way into the heavenly of heavenlies, the holy of holies. It's open for you this morning. He wants to bless you. Do you believe that? Say amen.
Amen.
He wants to bless you. Hallelujah. Talitha, he wants to bless you, girl. You just reach up and you get it from God because he loves you, girl. There ain't nothing holding you back. Go for it, man. Amen. Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name.
Amen. Let's worship him.
Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I'll worship your holy name. The sun comes up. It's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes.
Hallelujah, sing it out, church.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship his holy name.
Hallelujah.
Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I'll worship your holy name.
Amen.
You're rich in love, yes, and you're slow to anger.
Amen.
Your name is great. And your heart is kind.
Bless you, Lord.
For all the goodness I will keep on singing.
10,000 reasons.
10,000 reasons for my heart to find.
Here we go.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul.
Be lifted up.
Worship his holy name.
Hallelujah.
Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I'll worship your holy name. And on that day when my strength is failing and draws near and my time has come, still my soul sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore. Forevermore.
Yes.
Yeah. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I'll worship your holy name. Bless the Lord, oh, my
yes
soul. Oh, my soul.
Worship the Lord.
Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. I'll worship your holy name. Oh, yes, I will
worship your holy name.
Lord, I worship your holy name.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen. Good word.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. She's a walking miracle today. She was so sick last night she couldn't hardly sleep. She's here this morning.
Thank God.
Busting it through it, man. Amen. Hallelujah. Ah, this is a good song. Let's do this. Let's go into the Holy of Holies this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, God, take us into that holy place today. Thank you, Lord.
Take me past the outer courts into the holy place. Past the brazen altar, Lord, I want to see your face. Take me past the crowds of people and priests to sing your praise. I hunger and thirst for your righteousness, but it's only found in one place. Take me into the holy of holies. Take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me into the holy of holies. Take the coal, touch my lips, here I am. Take me past the outer courts to the holy place. Past the brazen altar, Lord, I want to see your face. Pass me by the crowds of people, priests to sing your praise. I hunger and thirst for your righteousness, but it's only found in one place. Take me into the holy of holies. Take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me into the holy of holies. Take the coal, touch my lips, here I am.
Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord, for drawing us to you.
Take me past the outer courts,
yes,
into the holy place. Past the brazen altar, Lord, I want to see your face. Pass me by the crowds of people and priests to sing your praise. I hunger and thirst for your righteousness, but it's only found in one place. Take me into the holy of holies. Take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me into the holy of holies. Take the coal, touch my lips, here I am. Take me into the holy of holies.
Thank you, Lord.
Take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me into the holy of holies. Take the coal, touch my lips, here I am. Take the coal, touch my lips, here I am. Take the coal, touch my lips, here I am.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we worship you, Lord, give you praise. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad you're here this morning instead of the hospital? Man, it's better to be here than on the eighth floor, I can tell you that. Amen. Better to be here than in jail, right, Kev? Where's Kevin at? Amen. Hallelujah. You you've got an opportunity this morning, the door is open. Let's worship him a little bit before we change the order. Amen? Just lift your hands. Just tell God how thankful you are for him this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, God, we give you praise. Hallelujah. We come boldly to the throne of grace, that we might obtain mercy, O God. We come boldly to the throne of grace, to get mercy and grace to help us in our time of need. We're a needy people today. We need him desperately today. Oh God, move in this place. Move in every heart today. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. If you need physical healing this morning, now's the time to come down and receive it. I believe it's here right now. If you need physical healing in your body, hallelujah. We got the oil down here. We'll anoint you. We'll believe God with you. Amen. Hallelujah. Talitha, I need to pray for you. You need to come here, girl. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Stretch your hands towards these. Father, thank you for touching my brother Ty. Lord, we just pronounce healing and wholeness in his body now in the name of Jesus, according to the word of God. Psalm 103:3 says, not only do you forgive us of all of our iniquities, you're the one who heals us of all our diseases. We believe tonight, today, every day, morning and night, God, that you are the great healer, Jehovah Rapha, our physician. I thank you right now for lifting this off of him in Jesus' name. Spirit of infirmity, I come against you in the name of Jesus. You cannot take this body. And I thank you for relieving his mind of all the pressure and the stress. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Man, you got to have that peace of mind, Ty. When we get stressed out mentally, it affects our body. And he's just saying right now, lift it up to me and let it go. Experience that peace of God that passes all understanding. Let it be that umpire of your life. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you now for that peace just flooding his spirit, man. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Wow. Thank you, Father. Amen. He's right here. Right here. Amen. Who else needs prayer for healing? Hallelujah. Deborah? Amen. Stretch your hands out towards Deb. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you for the woman of God. Lord, that your hand's upon her for healing. Oh, God, from the top of her head to the soles of her feet, in the mighty name of Jesus, we speak health and healing. Spirit of infirmity, get off of her in Jesus' name. I thank you, Father, that everything the enemy meant for evil, you're turning around for her good. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God, for the healing of Jesus flowing into her heart and mind in Jesus' name. Heal up that soul, God. We thank you for it in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Father, I thank you for this young boy that he has got great faith. Now, we're just going to mix our faith. You believe Jesus can heal you? Believe Jesus does heal you? Amen. Father, on the confession of his faith, he's healed by the very words that came out of his mouth. He's healed in Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you for it. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Father God, I thank you. Man, Talitha, I just hear this from the Holy Spirit so deeply, even when I looked at you this morning. God wants you to know he has not rejected you. You have not lost it. God would say, the steps of a righteous woman are ordered to the Lord. God's got a plan. You're walking the plan. Just keep going. Make the best decisions that are in front of you. He's going to guide you in that way. Do you believe that? Amen. So he's just saying this morning, quit condemning and knocking yourself down, because God doesn't do that. He's saying there is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set us free from the law of sin and the law of death. You are free, daughter, to go about the country in Jesus' name, to be the woman of God he's created you to be. It's a new day. It's a new day, Talitha. It's a new time. Rejoice in it. Enjoy it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And Will, everything that you've been praying for, God's answering. So get ready, brother. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you for this sister, and I thank you, God, right now for the divine touch of the Holy Spirit on her life in Jesus' name. Lord, she's a young handmaiden of God. I pray, God, that the attacks of the enemy against her will stop in Jesus' name. We come against them. We bind them now. We release her a spirit of love and joy and peace and a good, strong, sound mind in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Stretch your hands towards Henry. Father, I thank you for my brother. I thank you, God, that you have caused his life to be clean, and he's been clean and sober, God, and he's walking with you. Now, Lord, we just pray for this physical body that he's in. God, I come against everything that would come against him in Jesus' name. Health and healing. By the stripes on Jesus' back, we were, past tense, healed. We receive it. We thank you for it now in his body in Jesus' name. Let him rejoice and be glad in you, O God. Hallelujah. Many blessings ahead for you, brother. I think the enemy's tried to tell you that it's coming to a close, but God wants you to know this is a new beginning for you. That he's got great things in store for you. You haven't even scratched the surface yet of all the things he's got in store for you. So just walk with him. Amen? Keep going forward in Jesus' name. Sometimes you're just going to have to tell those things that bother you to get out of the way. I think you've been doing that. He's saying keep doing it. Keep talking to him and tell him you're not ruling my life. My spirit man is. And my spirit man says I'm healed in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Touch his wife, God. Touch Lola this morning, Father. Bless her, Lord. Father God, we lay hands on her in Jesus' name. Thank you for her, God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Man, Lola, God's just, he wants you to know he's got your children in his hands. He's taking care of them. Don't fret or be worrisome at all, for the Lord your God has got your children in his hand. He's taking care of them in ways that we don't even understand. And I know you love them. Guess what? God loves them even more and better than we do. Do you believe that? Amen. So he's got your family. He's holding it in his hands. He's going to bless your finances. Get ready. Don't fret nor be worried, for the Lord your God is with you, and he's going to cause your lives to continue to prosper in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Touch Linda too, Lord God, and heal her up from the top of her head to the soles of her feet. Spirit of depression, get away from her in Jesus' name. I command you to leave her alone. And I thank you for filling her Holy Spirit this morning. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm happy. Are you happy? Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you for Tim, Lord. Thank you, God, that you've laid your hands on him for good, not for evil. Touch his family, Father. Touch his dad. Touch his wife, his daughter, all of those that he cares about today, God. Touch them. And Father, I thank you for touching his physical body. Lord, we rebuke everything, the enemy, every spirit of infirmity the enemy would try to bring and lay it on this life. We come against it in Jesus' name. It will not prosper. He is healed in the name of Jesus. We give you praise and we thank you for it, Father God. Let his faith be lifted up. Encourage him, Lord God. Many miracles you've done here. Let that one more miracle be done in him. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Touch Mallory, Lord. Bless her, God. Thank you for moving and working in her children, working in her family, God, this morning. Lord, let her not be of a fretful or worrisome heart, but let her continue to sing and praise and worship the Lord, her God. Hallelujah. Just keep singing, girl. Hallelujah. Bless me when you do. Thank you, Father, for doing it in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Touch Greg this morning, Lord. Touch my brother, God. Continue to bring him further and further in his faith walk. I come against you, Satan. You cannot stop what God is doing. And God, I thank you right now for touching Greg and Tanya and the kids and their family and causing great peace and great joy to flood their family, great happiness in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. For you're doing mighty things in their family. Touch this girl, Lord. Touch her, God. Father, I thank you that you've laid your hand. I saw you worshiping today. God's going to cause you to be a worshiper of his. Hallelujah. Father, thank you for touching her. Let all discouragement go in the name of Jesus. And bless her abundantly, Father. Let it overflow into her life this morning. Amen. Woohoo! Hallelujah. Bless these girls. Amen, Lord. As they walk with you, Lord, keep them safe. Keep them pure before you, God. Protect them. Cause them, Father God, to walk with you all the days of their life. Heal them, Father, and Raise them up to serve you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. I need to get around you guys real quick. Love you. Amen. Bless her, Lord. Bless Alyssa, Father. Thank you for laying your hand upon her, God, and drawing her as a child unto you, God. Bless her abundantly in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Amen. Amen. I love you, sweetheart. You are healthy. We prayed for a healthy baby. That's what we got. Amen. Hallelujah. Bless his heart. Amen. Bless his mom. CJ, we bless you guys in Jesus' name. Father, thank you for Cassie. I thank you for touching her right now, blessing her, God, healing her heart. Now, Cassie, I know you've had some loss in your life. I lost my sister when she was 32. It's a hard thing. But God wants you to know is if you bring this to him, he'll heal your heart up. He's already started to do it with this little boy. He's going to do it more and more in the days ahead as you just focus on him. Slowly but surely, you're going to sense a real healing that's going to take place in your soul and in your heart, a real reconstructing of those things that are broken. That's his job. That's what he wants to do, is reconstruct your life. So as you're open to it, don't be in a hurry. Just let God do it step by step, here a little, there a little, and he's doing a great work in your life. Father, thank you for CJ. Bless that man. Touch him, God. Strengthen him as he stays clean, as he walks with you. Help him to make good choices, Lord. I thank you for protecting him. Hallelujah. One day at a time, one moment at a time, one step at a time, God. Thank you for blessing him as he completes, God, this calling on his life that you've called him for in Jesus' name. And bless this baby. Amen. Amen. Lots of people need healing today. Hallelujah. Father, yeah. Amen. Give her strength, Lord. As she goes through dialysis, I pray, God, that you'll just touch her, that you'll strengthen her and make these times special of just rest, and let her trust in you continue to grow in Jesus' name. We put a hedge about her of protection against the enemy and all his devices in Jesus' name. And I thank you, Father, for your blessing on her. Hallelujah. You're going to experience great peace in there, I believe. I really believe that. Amen. Thank you for doing it, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you for blessing, God. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah. All right, Martin. We need to pray for Martin this morning. He just had that surgery. Father, thank you. Thank you, Father. Lord, I thank you right now that he is healed in the name of Jesus. Ooh. Man, I feel a warmth coming through my hand to your stomach right now in Jesus' name. Thank you for healing that hernia, God, and causing him to be healed even faster than the doctors even thought. And they'll be amazed, Father, to hear his testimony of how good you've healed him and how quickly it's been. We thank you, Father, for doing it in Jesus' name. And I also hear the Holy Spirit telling me, listen to her, you're doing too much. Don't do too much. Listen to her, okay? You do that? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We prayed for them already. I'll pray for you. That's okay. We'll pray for you. Amen. Bless the woman of God. Touch her, Lord. Yeah, let her be happy in you, Father God. Bless her family. I thank you for touching all those she loves today, God. We lift her up to you and thank you for strengthening her in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. What's going on? What do we need to pray about? Say what? Okay. Okay. Are they running tests? Amen. Well, we know cancer or whatever it might be is little C. Jesus is big C. Amen. So, Father, we trust you this morning. We lay hands on our sister. He's not done with you. This is not going to happen. So be at peace. I don't know what it is, but he's got a calling on your guys' life. The enemy's trying to stop it, okay? And these lies that he's saying are trying to discourage you from believing and going forward, because he's got great plans for you both. There's a time for all of us. We all know that. But this time is not yet. God's not done with you yet, so be encouraged. Amen? Hallelujah. Father, thank you for encouraging her, blessing her from the top of her head to the soles of her feet in Jesus' name. Wow. Hallelujah. Monica, there's an anointing of God on you. Hallelujah. Many You're going to minister to many before this is through. Many young women, many children, God's going to use you to speak the word to, and you're going to be a blessing to many. Already are. Father, thank you for the man of God. Thank you for laying your hand on this brother. Let that spirit of prophecy break forth in his life. Let him continue to move in the gifts of the Spirit as you've given him. And God, let his heart rejoice. Let him not have any fear. I come against a spirit of fear that would try to grip them both in Jesus' name. I command it to go and to leave them alone in the name of Jesus. For you don't give us a spirit of fear. Hallelujah. Get into bondage, but you, our hearts cry out, Abba, Father. And I thank you, God, you've given us a spirit of love, power, and a good sound mind. Thank you for blessing them in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Great peace. Great peace of God. Amen. Father, thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you for Haley, God. Thank you that you laid your hand upon her. You know, Jeremiah 29:11 says, you don't know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They're not for hurt or destruction, but they're for good. Do you believe that? And he's got great plans for you, girl. Wonderful plans. But you got to walk through it step by step, right? Amen. It doesn't happen overnight. Hallelujah. The Lord's bringing you along just as he has designed to. Did you hear that? Just as he's designed you to do it, you're coming along just as he wants you to. So don't be a fretful heart. Don't worry about what's going on in this one or that one. For the Lord's put a wonderful spirit within you. A spirit that's compassionate. A spirit that loves children. A spirit that loves others. And there is leadership there as well. So just humble yourself before the Lord. Don't put yourself down. Don't listen to other people if they do. Because God has made you a beautiful woman of God. And he has set you apart for him special. There's many that have been here, but he set you apart special for him. But you got to believe that and receive that now in Jesus' name. Wow, there's a real battle for your soul. The enemy wants to just destroy you because he's afraid of you. He's afraid of what you can do if you're confident and bold and feeling strong about who you are in Christ. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you for doing it in Jesus' name. Encourage her, Lord. We lift her up to you. And we thank you for your blessing on her in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Father God, thank you for healing in Jesus' name. From the top of her head to this. Whoa, to this. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Man. Terry, Spirit of God's all over you. Looking in your soul. And he's healing that too right now in Jesus' name. Wow. Thank you, Father. That which you've asked for, you receive it now in the name of Jesus. It's there. It's right there. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Amen. Father, thank you for my brother. Hallelujah. Yeah. Thank you, Father God. Just as Samson rose up with great strength, as the Spirit of God came upon him, Lord, let Scott Armstrong step up in great strength as the Spirit of God comes upon him. Touch his hip. Heal everything, Father God, the way that you know is best. And Father, I thank you for strengthening his heart and his soul. As he walks with you, fill him up. He's just open, God. He's desirous of going deeper with you. Let him do that, Father God, in Jesus' mighty name. Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. All right, Father, we lay hands on this woman of God, this new mother. God, she's been so blessed. She's come so far. God, I thank you this morning that you receive her, that you accept her. Father God, your word says that we are accepted in the beloved. In Ephesians 1:6, God, you've accepted us. You've accepted her, that we can come as we are and leave different. Thank you, Father God, for right now we come against every spirit of depression and anxiety. Wow, this is a battle. I can sense this battle right now, Sheila. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you right now for the healing power, the balm of Gilead flowing from the top of her head to the soles of her feet. I thank you, God, that you don't give her a spirit of... You know where this comes from, Sheila. You're going to have to start rebuking it too. In Jesus' name, we rebuke this spirit of the enemy that would bring this depression, this drawing back to the darkness. We command it to stop now in Jesus' name. The weapons of our warfare are not human, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of every stronghold, bringing every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. That's the word. Father, we speak that word over her now in Jesus' name. Satan, you can have no part. You have been destroyed. Jesus was manifest to destroy the works of the devil, and he did it. Hallelujah. So we bind it all up right now by the crowns on his, on the thorn of crown of thorns on his head. We bind up every evil spirit against this woman of God, and we release to her a spirit of love and joy and soundness of mind in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Now listen, my old pastor used to say that our thought life is like a chimney, and the bad thoughts are like these pigeons flying around. You know, and you can't stop them from flying around, but you can stop them from nesting in your chimney. Just keep telling them to leave. Get out of here. I'm not going to think those thoughts. Look at your husband. Look at that baby. Think of all of us that love you. Think of him. You're going to make it through this, but it's going to be a battle. You're going to have to fight it. Call me. Text me. We'll pray right then. Even if we're not together, we'll pray and we'll come against it in Jesus' name. Any of us, yeah, amen. Hallelujah. Go in peace. Hallelujah. Bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Okay, have you guys received Jesus before? If not, would you like to receive Jesus? Okay, just grab my hand. All right, here's what I want you to pray. Just follow after me. You ready? Father God, I come to you now in Jesus' name. I ask you to forgive me of my sins. I believe Jesus is alive. And I ask and invite him into my heart now in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, the scripture says, if you believe this in your heart, you're saved. You're saved as I am. Do you believe that? Amen. Well, you are. What's your first name?
Michael.
Congratulations. You have brand new life. You're a new creation. God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. Yeah. He's been tugging at your heart for a while. Amen. Stretch your hands out to this couple. We're going to pray for them. Amen. Amen. Father, I thank you for Michael that he's accepted Jesus today into his heart. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says that if anyone's in Christ, they are a new creation. He's a new man. Hallelujah. That the old is gone, and behold, all things are new. I thank you for the new life in him. Bless his wife. Bless their family. Bless their relationship. Bless their finances. Touch them, God. Prosper them in every way possible. And we thank you now for covering them with your Holy Spirit, with your love, and with your acceptance in Jesus' name. And everybody said amen. Woohoo! I've been to church, y'all. Hallelujah!
Take me into the Holy of Holies. Take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me into the Holy of Holies. Take the coal, touch my limbs, here I am. Take me into the Holy of Holies.
Hallelujah.
Take me in by the blood of the Lamb.
Amen.
Take me into the Holy of Holies. Take the coal, touch my limbs, here I am. Take the coal, touch my lips.
Hallelujah.
Here I am.
Thank you, Lord.
Take the coal, touch my lips. Here I am.
Oh, give the Lord a hand. Great things that he has accomplished today.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise God Almighty. Hallelujah. Well, you can be seated if you can this morning. Praise God. Yes, tomorrow is my birthday, but I don't want anybody to know. to you. It's Shane's birthday too. Shane, happy birthday. Thank you. I just want to say that I really, really appreciate that heartfelt song. Can I tell you though, my jokes are better than your singing. That's just saying. Happy birthday, Shane. He's a little bit younger than me, but we appreciate him. Yeah, a
little bit.
Hallie, I'll tell you what, this has been awesome today. How about I'm just so blessed to be here this morning, and so glad to have our friends back in town. I'll explain more about that in a minute, but before that, I'm going to have Ty come. You can turn the house lights up if you would. I'll have Ty come with his cohort. We'll take up this morning's offering. Amen. Hallelujah. And I think Ty's wife has a brief praise report you wanted to share. Go ahead, D. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. That's wonderful. Hallelujah. Our God is good to us, isn't he? Amen. And Mr. and Mrs. Fryman, congratulations. We're so glad you're here. God bless you guys. We're really glad you're here this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Wow. What a great day. And I want to thank Connie for the gift of the Yoda cake. We have a Yoda cake for lunch today. So I hope you stay and have a piece of Yoda cake. Amen. Hallelujah. If you've got your offering, I haven't had a chance to write my check yet, but I will. If you've got your offering, let's lift it up before the Lord this morning. We believe God for great blessing for those that give and those that don't. But especially if you give, if you at least give something, he gives you some kind of seed to sow, he'll give you more. Amen. Do you believe that? I've seen it happen over and over. Amen. I see all these little kids. They got their hands up with something in it. Good. Praise God. All right. Bow your heads with me and let's pray. Father, we thank you for all of your wondrous blessings. God, you're so gracious and so generous to us. Help us to be as generous as you are, Lord. I pray you bless everyone that gives this morning, that they sow it as seed in good ground and receive a great harvest. Let them receive it pressed down, shaken together, and running over. God, may it be given back into their life in so many different ways. We thank you. We rejoice in you. We love you. We bless you. In Jesus' name. And everybody said amen. Amen.
Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit.
Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Oh, in your presence, Lord.
Amen. I could put that on a loop and keep hearing that over and over again. How about you this morning? Isn't that wonderful? Hallelujah. Well, let me tell you this. Heather was the first worship leader at this church. She did it all by herself for a while. Amen. Yeah, Chris helped a lot. Yeah, and then Ian and all that. Yeah, that was great. Before I dismiss the kids to Kid Zone, while everybody is in here, 10 years ago, August of 2006, well, actually, prior to that, in June, we felt called, as many of you know, I've already shared that story. I'm not going to beleaguer that point of coming here and starting a church on Derby Street. And, you know, my mom was going to come with me because she has to. Debbie had to come, too. She didn't really want to, but she had to, too. And Chris and his family came. And then Douglas and Heather came to me once and said, we want to go, too. And I said, no, you guys are goofy. You don't want to come with us. You stay where you're at. It's too good of a place, you know. And they said, no, we really feel called to come. So we had seven people in our first service down the street in August 2006. And there's many times, many things have happened over the years. 2 years later, you guys moved, right, to Virginia. And that's where you're going this afternoon to see her parents out there, which is awesome. I'm glad you guys get a chance to see them. But I'm glad you got a chance to come here. I'll let Douglas share more if he wants to, but he's been called to the ministry ever since I've known him. And now they're in Florida, and I can't remember the name of the church you're at. What's it called? Faith Farm. That's good. They're farming faith down there. They're throwing seeds of faith, and the faith's coming up like a farm. That's good. We all need that. Amen. But Douglas came and ministered a couple years ago, did a great job. So when he was going to come, I asked him if he would. I just want you to know these are two of the most precious people in our life. They have meant a lot to us over the years, even though we aren't in the same vicinity. And I'm so proud of what they're doing and who they are and where they're going. Man, I just sense great things for you guys.
Yes.
That Faith Farm is great, but that's not the end all be all. There's other things he's got for both of you. Great things. Pastoral things, I think. I remember one time, and you probably remember this too. I was driving in my car, and I just got... In fact, Gary did this. Gary Cave did this to me one day, too. I had this word on my heart. I said, I just got to call Douglas or I text. I think we had text back then. That's how long ago it was. But I think I called him and I said, God's calling you to be a disciple of love. And he said, not me, man. No way. That ain't me. Get out of here. You didn't hear from God. No, he didn't say that. But he was like, no way. And then one day, I don't know how many years ago it was, Douglas, that you Facebook messaged me or something and said, I think that word has come true. God can make you love people even when you don't.
Amen.
And he can give you a heart of compassion because he's got a heart of compassion for us. And I know you're doing great things down there. I read about them and hear about them. But I don't know, brother. Be open, man. You guys just be open to what God's got called for you to do because I don't know. I just see you pastoring folks. More folks. Huh? Yes, we do need pastors in this last day. Amen. Announcements-wise, Saturday is men's and women's fellowship. Be here at 10 so you can help decorate. Amen. We're going to decorate the building. Amen. Amen. We're going to put little, I'm going to have a little buzzer up here under each chair. Yes, amen. Okay. All right. Amen. Don't bother me. Get away from me, boy, you bother me. But anyway, that's next Saturday at 10. And be praying about our Christmas service. Right now I'm leaning to Christmas Eve at 6, from 6 to 7. I think we've got some voting things back here. I don't know where Connie went back here. We've only got 4 votes, and they're all what, same? Pretty close. They're probably all different. That's really great. But anyway, that's what we're looking at right now. So if you'd like to vote on that, let us know what you would like to do for service. Okay, children, we'll dismiss you to Kid Zone. We don't get mail down there. You talk about the blessing room?
No, her, where she
lives. Oh, where you live. Okay, you confused me there for a minute. Well, we'll pray against that in Jesus' name. Amen. I think you should. All right. We make special allowances for moms. Amen. Oh, you're welcome. All right. Stand if you would. We're going to pray. I'm going to have Douglas come up and get ready to minister the word. You got your mic on? Let him get his microphone on. Amen. Bow your heads if you would real quick. Father, we thank you this morning for the word of God. Father God, we need your word desperately. And we just thank you this morning for blessing our brother and anointing him with the Holy Spirit and the word of God. Let him speak as an oracle of God. Let him speak with confidence this morning. And Lord, we thank you that you're going to give us all a hearing ear. Let us all hear what the Spirit of the Lord would say to the church this day, November 27, 2016. We thank you for that. We bless him now, and we bless you for blessing us in Jesus' name. And everybody said amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So from Florida, wanting to stay here because of the weather.
I'm free. Now you just obey God. All right. Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
Let's do that again. Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
Am I loud enough?
Yeah.
Yeah, this works for you guys? All right. Would you go ahead and turn to John chapter 14? Can I get down here and wander around? Is that all right with you guys?
Yeah.
So, as Mark said, it was 10 years ago that he knocked on our front door and said, I'm supposed to go to Derby Street. I had a dream. I'm supposed to go to Derby Street. And we're like, what are you going to do? You're gonna pawn something? You got to buy a gun? What are you doing? And he said, no, I'm supposed to go to Derby Street. And I looked at her, and she looked at me and said, okay, we'll go too. And it was about 6 weeks later, we got some free pews and slapped a coat of paint on a building, and we started a church. It should be much more difficult to start a church. They'll let anybody do it. You just got to hang out a sign and open up the doors, and they'll let you preach. And that really started something, and it is a great honor for me today to be in Pastor Mark's pulpit. He has poured so much into our life and into our ministry and really set us up for what we do today. And in sitting over here next to my wife is Brother Bob Coker, who is another great man of God who's done the same. And between the two of them, we were very, very well equipped to go and spread the grace of God. And today we are privileged to pastor at a men's addiction recovery center in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And so we have about 150 guys from all walks of life, some, you know, from Catholic backgrounds, Methodist, Baptist, Pentecostal, whatever, but many of which were, like myself, before I was saved, complete heathens. And so we have a wide range of traditions and ideas and views, and people who come in some of the worst shape you can imagine, who have gone through some of the worst things, things that just would pull the mind to hear you, if you were to hear some of the stories of the things that they've been through in the depths of their addiction. And it is an amazing, amazing ministry to see the transformation that takes place. It's a 10-month program, and in that time, the way that their lives are completely turned around is phenomenal. And it is amazing to see God work. And so it is literally the most fruitful ministry we've ever seen. They bring us unsaved men every week. We have physical healing every week. We have emotional healing every week. Deliverance every week. It's amazing. And we live right there on campus. We have a house right next to the church. So my commute is literally from here to that wall. I don't have to be out there in all that traffic. And so in the evenings we'll go out to eat, and 2 miles that way there's a they keep an ocean down there. Wow. And while we don't often go to the beach, we will go on the next to the beach and get something to eat and just listen to the waves and the birds. Now, two miles this way where we live, we're in the hood. It's a very dangerous area. The kids don't get out and go walk because it's a very dangerous area, but we're 2 miles away from paradise. So it is, we're so blessed. And there is not a day goes by that we just don't stop and say, man, we are so blessed. But it all started, well, not here, down there. Just a few blocks down that way. We leave you guys alone for 5 minutes and you get a brand new building. And this is awesome. This is amazing. And I want to go back to where we're from and replace our nice coral wall with this tent, because this is awesome. I love this. I hope you guys feel blessed, because this is amazing. Before I get started this morning, where's the young man that was just saved? Is this you, Michael? Your name means like unto God. Are you aware of this? Like unto God. And as of this moment, you are exactly like unto God. Everything, and I want you to spend the rest of your life studying what Jesus is like, because from this moment forward, everything that's true of Jesus is true of you. Amen. And I heard Mark say it a little while ago, you're forgiven of your sins, but I really felt in the spirit that you had this thought in the back of your mind, says, well, but not that one. And I don't know what it is, he didn't reveal that to me, but you're thinking he can't possibly forgive you for that. But I'm here to tell you that you are completely forgiven of everything that you have ever done and ever will do. Everything that is true of Jesus is true of you. And if you will spend your life finding out what that is, it will manifest in your life and it will affect everybody around you in ways you can't even begin to imagine. That is his will for you. That is his will. It's to you to be like him. Somebody say amen. This is, I am quite certain, because I was here at the beginning, this is a charismatic church, and that means that certain things here are quite acceptable. One of those things is that you say amen when the preacher says something you agree with. Amen. You are welcome to shout. You are welcome to holler. And sometimes when it's really good, if somebody in the back's got a really deep voice, you might just go, preach. There you go. Right? So we are ready to get started. Now, Mark has given me a time limit. I'm not sure exactly what it is. There are preachers in the world that can preach briefly. None of those preachers are in the room today. So what is my time limit? If I'm going too long, would you like to tell me to steal second or whatever you got to do here? Okay. That? Yeah. Okay. That just means I'm sick of you. That's what that means. We know we love Debbie. We love Debbie. And Grandma PJ is here. She's still alive. And Ty. So, did I ask you to turn to John chapter 14? Okay. In John chapter 14, Jesus and the disciples are together in a rented room. They don't live in Jerusalem. They've gone to Jerusalem for the festival. It's Passover. And they've rented a room, and they're having what we know as the Last Supper. Okay? And Jesus is beginning to explain to them what is about to happen. Judas has already left the room. He's gone off to run his infamous errand. And Jesus is telling them that he is about to leave the earth, and they are not receiving this. But he says, starting in verse 12, "Very truly I tell you, whoever believes in me will do the works I have been doing, and they will do even greater things than these because I'm going to the Father." I want to pause here before I go on, because Jesus says that if you believe in him, do you believe in him?
Yes.
So whatever he says next counts for you, correct?
Yes.
Say, it counts for me.
It counts for me.
If you believe in me, you will do the works that I have been doing. Amen. What has Jesus been doing? He's been, well, in most churches, they would tell you what Jesus has been doing is living a sinless life.
Amen.
Right?
Right.
And that's true. He has been. And then, but the way it's produced is, the way it's usually presented is, Jesus lived a sinless life, now you better do it too. So knock that stuff off, you worthless bag of snot. And that's where they quit. But the correct answer came right here. What has Jesus been doing? He's been going around healing everybody. He's been going around casting out devils. He's been going around cleansing lepers. He's been going around raising the dead. He's been going around bringing the very presence of God into every single situation that he's in. He's bringing the kingdom. Where the king is the kingdom. And Jesus says, if you believe in me, you're going to do the things that I do. Why is this important? Because y'all came from somewhere. Don't look at me that way. I spent 5 years in West Virginia. I'm legally permitted to use the word y'all. I'm from here, but I lived there, so I can say y'all. Y'all came from somewhere. Some kind of a life. Some kind of a lifestyle. And if the new lifestyle in Christ is not more satisfying to you than the life you came from, you will go right back to it. You were not saved so that you can sit your hindquarters on a pew or even one of these very comfortable chairs, way better than what we had. You were not saved so you can set your hindquarters on a pew for an hour a week. You were not saved even so you can go to church, though that is a wonderful thing. But Jesus didn't say, build it and they will come. That was Kevin Costner. Jesus said, go ye into all the world. You were not saved to go to church. You were saved to bring the kingdom of God, the culture and government of heaven to the earth in every interaction and every relationship you have for the rest of your days. That's what this is all about. Michael, what you just did right here was receive the presence of God in you. Now Jesus is in you. And here's the secret that church doesn't tell you. He wants out. He wants out. Where does he want out? Every time you have any interaction with another human being, whether it's just the checkout girl at the grocery store or your wife, whether it is a long-term relationship or a very temporary interaction, Jesus wants to be manifest in that.
Amen.
If you believe in me, you will do the things I have been doing. What has he been doing? He has been being God on earth. And if you believe in him, you will do the same. But he doesn't stop there. And even greater things than these, because I'm going to the Father. In other words, if I stay here, and you would think that if Jesus were right here in the room with us, that would be really cool. Right? Everybody who just came forward for healing, for physical and emotional issues, if Jesus were standing right here, you would go, okay, this is my day. I'm getting healed. This is it, right? So let's do a thought experiment with me. If you were, let's just imagine yourself crossing a dark parking lot by yourself at night. And from behind a van, a guy steps out, and you can tell that he is in dire need of whatever is in your pocket, so that he can take it to his drug dealer, and he is not in his right mind, and he has a gun. How do you feel? You're scared. You're scared. And that's perfectly reasonable. In that situation, you should be scared. Fear is reasonable. But let's say in just a moment, right behind that man appears a 9-foot angel with wings out to here and a 9-foot glowing sword over his back. Now how do you feel? You feel safe, don't you? The fear has gone. Now you feel quite safe. You feel protected. But what if instead of the angel, you look over the man's shoulder, and there is Jesus himself? Woo. Now, not only do you feel safe, you're actually kind of excited. Yeah. Because you know that not only am I safe, but this man's going to get healed. He's going to get set free. Yeah. This is his moment. Woo. And I get to be here for it. That's awesome. So we all know that if Jesus were here, it would just be awesome, right? But Jesus says, it's better for you that I go away. Because if I go away, then you're going to do the stuff I'm doing and even greater things. But if I stay, you won't. What is he talking about? In verse 16, he explains, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper to come and be with you forever. That word helper is also translated as advocate, counselor, and comforter. It's a Greek word, parakletos, which is fun to say. And in wherever that Greek word appears in Greek literature, it has the connotation of someone who appears on another's behalf, someone who appears as someone else. It does not generally have the connotation of lawyer or attorney. But what it really means is someone who shows up when you're supposed to be there, this person shows up for you. That's a parakletos. That's the helper. That is someone who appears as you and for you in the courts of heaven and wants to appear as you and for you in every single moment of your life from here onward. He wants to show up in your life from here forward in every single thing that you do. He wants to do it for you. Here's the thing, Michael, I keep coming back to you because you're just now saved. This thing that he wants you to do is to go into all the world and carry the presence of God. But he doesn't ask you to do it on your own. He's now in you, and he just wants you to let him do it. Amen. And the more successful you are at learning how to get your flesh out of the way and now to let Jesus be Jesus, the more successful you're going to be at a Christian life. It turns out that it is absolutely impossible to live a Christian life. Only Christ can live a Christian life.
Yeah.
You can't do it.
No.
Jesus can. The good news is, he's in you.
Yes.
And the more successful you are at getting your flesh out of the way and letting him be him, the more Jesus stuff is going to happen in your life.
Amen?
Amen?
Amen.
So, he's going to take your place. Jesus is telling him, the disciples, that his physical presence with them will be replaced by another helper. Another helper. You notice the word another means that Jesus considers himself to be their helper.
Yeah.
And he's sending another, someone's going to replace him. Well, Jesus can't be replaced by someone that isn't like him.
Right. Yeah.
So by saying, I'm sending you my replacement, Jesus is saying he's just like me. Are you with me so far? Otherwise, how could this Holy Spirit that he's talking about. I'll get right to the point here. He's talking about the Holy Spirit. How can Jesus consider the Holy Spirit to be equal to himself if the Holy Spirit isn't himself? Because Jesus is God on earth. God came to earth as a man in the person of his own son. And he says, I'm about to leave, but when I go, that's even better for you because I'm going to send you another helper to replace me. Look, notice he does not say, I'm going to send you a non-personal abstract power. I'm sorry, Pastor Mark, this is not use the force, Luke. This is not some neo-pagan nature spirit. This is not Allah. This is not Buddha. This is not Confucius. This is not Vishnu. This is not any of that. This is the God of the Hebrews, the God of Abraham and of Isaac and of Jacob, come to earth as a man, ascended to heaven, and come back inside of me. My physical presence among you is going to be replaced by my spiritual presence within you. And now you can go do my stuff and even greater things than these. Have you noticed that Jesus did some great things? We've already mentioned healing and casting out demons, but did you notice that he calmed a storm with a word? Did you notice that he walked on water? Had command over nature itself. That is some amazing stuff. Now, we have seen some physical healing. It happens in Pastor Mark's ministry. It happens in my ministry. It happens in Bob's ministry. It occurs all over the world today. Physical healing is a real thing. We see emotional healing. People set free of things they've been carrying around for 40 years, set free in a moment. We see devils cast out and people delivered from demonic oppression all the time, but I've never to this day ever heard of anybody walking on water or calming a storm. I've heard some amazing things. And I make a habit of whenever I have an appointment canceled or I've got a moment free, I will get on YouTube and I will just feed myself testimonies of miracle-working ministries around the world. Because if it can happen in that ministry, it can happen in this ministry.
Amen.
And I want to just take a moment here and encourage you to do the same. If you are struggling financially, go look up some financial miracles. If you are struggling emotionally, go look up some emotional miracles. If you're struggling with personally, go look up some with your marriage or whatever, go look up some miracles that have happened to that and just begin to feed yourself those testimonies because they will encourage you and they will empower you to have faith for what you need.
Amen.
Good. That was free of charge. That's not even in my notes. So back to John chapter 14 because I stopped in the middle of a sentence. In the next verse, he finishes that. He says, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to help you, another helper, who will be with you forever, the Spirit of Truth. Now, Jesus has already identified himself in the same conversation about eight or so verses previous. He identifies himself when he says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So Jesus says, I am the truth. And when I leave, the Spirit of Truth, I'm the truth. I'm going to send you the Spirit of Truth. Whose Spirit is he sending? His own Spirit. His own Spirit. He absolutely clarifies this at the end at verse 18 when he says, I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. So the Holy Spirit is whom? The Holy Spirit is Jesus. So we pray Father and Son and Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is Jesus. The Son is Jesus. The Father is Jesus. The Father is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, they're one. It's what's this called a mystery. In John chapter 8, Jesus had said, then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Two verses later, he says, and if the Son shall set you free, you shall be free indeed. The name of my first ministry right over here in Groveland was Free Indeed Ministries. Because my approach to ministry is not to advise or to counsel, but simply to set you up with an encounter with the Spirit of Truth and let him speak into you. What am I talking about? You are not in pain today because of the things that happened to you when you were young. You are not suffering today because you were molested when you were 7 years old. You are suffering today because when that happened, You believed that it defiled you. You believed that it made you unlovable. You believed that it made you dirty. You believed that it made you unclean. And that is a lie.
Amen. Amen.
That is a lie. So when the Spirit of Truth comes and He speaks to you in that memory and says, you are perfect, you are pure, you are clean, and you are loved, I love you so much, it breaks the lie and replaces it with the truth.
Yeah.
And when the truth sets you free,
you are free indeed.
And you can go through every single one of the places where you have emotional pain and what we call personality issues. No, you don't have any, but the person sitting next to you is a complete wreck. Don't look around. Look up here. You can go into every single one of your personality issues and little quirks and ask the Lord, what is the lie I believe? Where does that come from? And He'll take you to a memory of your first girlfriend or that thing that happened in second grade or the person who should have protected you but actually victimized you and say, okay, well, what is it that I believe that's false there? Well, you believe that that made you something bad. Well, Lord, what's the truth? The truth is that affected them, not you. You were completely innocent. You are not responsible for that. You could not have stopped it. You were a child. They were an adult. They should have. And He will speak truth to you and set you free in that. And He, because He is the Spirit of Truth. This truth shall set you free. Truth sets you free. This is how you can know that Pastor Mark is preaching right. Because when he preaches, and I can say this having not been here in years, I know your pastor. And I know that the way he preaches, and I know that when he preaches, you get set free because he's bringing you truth.
Amen. Yeah.
But if any of you ever find yourself parked in another church, you will know if the word is being brought correctly, because anytime you hear the word preached and you go, I suck. I got a long way to go. I'm bad. Anytime that what is being preached puts you in bondage, it's not truth. It's error. Because truth sets you free.
Amen.
That's all truth does. It always sets you free. If you can be put in bondage by the truth, you just can't be. Truth sets you free.
Amen.
Right? So anytime somebody is bringing you a word, or even if you're just hearing it in a way that is making you feel bound, like you are a mess, like you are just completely screwed up, then you've got to understand that you're either hearing it wrong or it's being brought wrong or both, because truth will always set you free. Amen?
Amen.
In John chapter 16, how am I doing? Am I good on time? I'm kind of rushing. We're all right? In John chapter 16, Jesus says that the Spirit of Truth will bring me glory by telling you whatever He receives from me. So we know that the Holy Spirit wants to speak with you. Because every time He speaks with you, He is bringing glory to Jesus. That is the Holy Spirit's role, to bring glory to Jesus. And He does it by speaking Jesus' stuff to you.
Yes.
And yes, for those of you who are just joining us, this crazy preacher is saying that God is speaking to you today.
Yes.
Right now. And every moment of your life, He is speaking to you. It's only a matter of, are you listening? Let's pause a moment. Everybody just remain quiet and tell me, can you hear the music? Do you hear it? Did anybody hear the music? No. But if I were to turn on a radio, music would fill the room. Did the radio create music? No. It only is a receiver for the music that is being piped into this room every moment of every day by all these different radio stations. It's the same way with the voice of God. He is constantly broadcasting to you. We just don't have our receivers tuned in, because we are so busy with all of the other stuff of life. Our culture is so loud. We get 50-some thousand advertising impressions every day. We always have the television on or the radio on or whatever it is that Dallas has on her iPod thingy over here. She's got 87,000 different social media things on her phone. If the phone would go, she wouldn't know how to live if the phone were to go dead.
I withdraw.
She's addicted to her charger.
Yep.
And we all do this. Where we live now, you can't even though we live in paradise, you can't have the windows down at any stoplight because the music being pumped out of the car next to you at a volume that would absolutely bust your eardrums with the most profane, foul stuff. Because and the woman in the car will be there with kids. But they're so terrified of having a moment alone and quiet to just listen for the voice of God. Michael, as you step into this new life, I want to encourage you to just take a little time each morning, maybe get up 15, 20 minutes earlier than you really need to, and just spend that time in the quiet and just listen. Just listen for the voice of God. And when you find him, just tune your radio there and lock it in. And set that there. Because if you will start your day with him, he will take care of the rest of your day. Amen. He'll take care of the rest of your day. You'll come to... See what we do when we come in prayer? We show up. Here's our prayer. Lord, here's all my stuff today. And puke it all up. Thank you. Goodbye. See you tomorrow. What is the point of going to the person who has all the answers if you never shut up and let him speak? I want to encourage all of you to spend at least 50% of your prayer time listening rather than speaking. Amen. Preferably the first 50%. Because by the time you get to talk, he may have already answered your stuff. And now you can just go on. And what does he want to tell you? He wants to tell you how much he loves you. Amen. He wants to tell you how awesome you are, what an amazing things he has in store for you. I'm only going to tell you the next step because if I told you what you'd be doing 3 years from now, you would panic and run away. So I'm only going to tell you this part. Right? If we had known what Mark was going to do, we would have. Right? But we would never have dreamed that it would have brought us to a rehab center. It would have terrified us. But today, after sitting under Mark's leadership, under receiving Bob's ministry and several others, we're ready because we spent that time receiving. You got to receive before you can give. Jesus to give to other people through you. Have you ever heard of anybody with a financial situation they were praying about and they were just walking down the street one day and a bag of money fell out of the sky and hit him in the head? No. Never. If you're going to get blessed, it's going to come from the hand of one of his people. If anybody else is going to get blessed, it's going to come from you following his leadership and doing his stuff. If anybody's going to get healed, it would be there because you were there to lay hands on them and pray for them. Nobody's going to get healed if you don't do it. If anybody's going to get a demon cast out of them, it will be because you were there to take authority and tell it that it must go. And if you don't, they won't. If anybody's going to get brought back from the dead, it'll be because you were there to rebuke death and tell life to come back. And if you don't, they won't. Jesus isn't going to show up and do it. He sent you. You, with everything that you've been through, with all the junk that you've survived, with everything that you have done, you are the agent and ambassador of the Lord Jesus Christ on planet Earth. He chose you. He chose you. He will not show up to do it. He chose you. He said, you go. And listen, in John chapter 20, when the moment the disciples are born again, Jesus shows up in the middle of the upper room. And he says, as my Father has sent me, so send I you. In the same way I was sent, I'm sending you. How did Jesus come to earth? Born as a baby. Born. He says, as the Father sent me, born, so send I you. Receive ye the Holy Spirit. And he breathes on them. This is the moment that the disciples are born again. His very next thing he says, the very next breath, he says, if you forgive anyone's sins, they're forgiven. Now, only God can forgive sins. They wanted to stone Jesus for doing it because only God can do it. He did it. And the moment the disciples are born again, he said, now go do God stuff. Only God can do it. Receive the Holy Spirit. Now go do God stuff. Only Jesus can do it. Here's Jesus in you. Now you go do it. Yeah. You are commissioned, called to go do Jesus stuff every day. Amen. You are not to just go to work, mow the yard, pay the bills, and argue over where you want to go to supper. That's existing, but that's not living. Living is going and doing Jesus stuff every day. Every day. And it is so satisfying. It is so empowering that you will look back on the life you led before and you will go, I can't believe I ever wasted time in that junk. That seems so meaningless now. I thought that was satisfying. I look back now and it was just a waste of time. I look back, I was saved when I was 37 years old. That was like over 2 years ago. And I look back at the 37 years before that thinking, man, I was just wasting time up until then. What could I have done if I had had the presence of God in me for those 37 years? And all the stuff that back then I thought was satisfying turned out was only temporarily satisfying. And the stuff I do today is eternally satisfying. I pray for you that eternal satisfaction. God wants to speak with you. Because every time he does, the Spirit of truth glorifies Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. Also in John chapter 16, in verse 8, Jesus is talking about the Holy Spirit and says that when he has come, he will convict the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. Before I unload this, I want to caution you. Who here was raised in church? We have anybody here that was raised up in church? Your folks raised you right. Okay. If you're sitting around one of the people that just raised their hand, I would like you to move away because it is entirely possible that as we get into this scripture, that their heads are going to explode. And I don't want you to get messy on your nice clothes. We're going to look at this scripture because this has been preached wrong to you all your life. If you were raised in church, you've heard that based on this scripture, the Holy Spirit will convict sin. Have you heard that? Anybody ever heard that? I want to tell you that's not the truth. You've heard many times that he wants to convict you of sin, but it is not true. You can't take verse 8 out of the context of verses 9 through 11. Amen. You got to take Bible scripture in the context that it's written with all the other scriptures around it, the entire chapter sometimes, because it is easy to take a scripture out by itself and twist it around to say, and sometimes even the exact opposite of what it really meant. Let's start again with verse 8. When he has come, he will convict the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. Verse 9. Of sin, because they do not believe in me. Amen. Of righteousness, because I go to my Father and you see me no more. Of judgment, because the ruler of this world is judged. Now let me ask you a question. We're going to start with verse 11. Are you the ruler of this world? By the way, that is the devil, Satan. Are you him?
No.
Then, since the Holy Spirit convicts the ruler of this world of judgment, if you're not the ruler of this world, will he convict you of judgment?
No.
Will the Holy Spirit convict you of judgment? Why? Because you're not the devil. Let's get back to verse 9. Of sin, because they do not believe in me. Are you a non-believer? Come on, are you a non-believer?
No.
Then will the Holy Spirit convict you of sin? Oh. Do you remember before you were saved? Do you remember before you were saved, anytime someone would mention the name of Jesus, you got uncomfortable? The world right now is divided completely between people that rejoice at the name of Jesus and people who lose their ever-loving minds at the name of Jesus. They really don't care if you talk about God. That's okay, because they can envision whatever God they want to. Anything they like. They can wrap up a God in their own image, in their own creation, and they can be comfortable with, oh, well, you have a higher power. Wonderful. That's very nice. But when you talk about Jesus, they get very, very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
A few years ago, I was sitting up late, and I was watching comedy on TV, the one with the wall behind them, you know, and the comedian stepped out, and just, you know, in that small talk they make at the beginning, he says, I know what let's do. Let's talk about Jesus, because that really makes people feel comfortable. And there was nervous laughter around the room. Do you remember before you were saved how uncomfortable you got when people would talk about Jesus? Do you know that is the Holy Spirit convicting them? That's this verse in action. Amen. The Holy Spirit convicting the unbeliever. Notice that he doesn't convict the unbeliever of adultery and thieving and cheating on their taxes. He's not convicting them of sins. He's convicting them that they need to believe in Jesus. The role of the Holy Spirit is to convict the unbeliever that he needs to believe. To take someone like Michael, who moments ago did not believe, but now he believes and he has been reborn. And now everything he's ever done and ever will do is washed away.
Amen.
Gone completely forever. God says, I will remember your sins no more forever.
Amen.
I recommend you don't remind him of them. Gone. And the Holy Spirit will convict you, if you're an unbeliever, convict you of your need to become a believer. And that's why people are so uncomfortable at the name of Jesus. It's not because of their sins. No one goes to hell because of his sins. They go to hell because of their unbelief in Jesus Christ. So Hitler is not in hell today because he killed millions and millions of people. He is in hell today because he did not believe in Jesus Christ. Osama is not in hell today for all the things that he done. He's in hell today because he refused to believe in Jesus Christ. And you will not go to hell for your sins. You'll only go to hell if you refuse to believe in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's
Come on.
All. But we're not even talking about you yet because you're already a believer. You are in verse 10. Of righteousness. Because I go to the Father. Listen, because he's going to the Father, sending the Holy Spirit will convict you of righteousness. He's convicting the devil of judgment. He's convicting the unbeliever of sin. He's convicting the believer of righteousness. He's convicting the believer of righteousness. That is a religious term, and what it really means is you have right standing with God.
Yeah.
You have a membership card that says member in good standing. That means I have righteousness. Me and God, we're good. We're in good shape. This relationship is fine, and now I can turn around and focus on this relationship. Because this one is okay. He will convict you of your righteousness. He will convict you of your holiness. He will convict you of your perfection. He will convict you of your purity. He will convict you that you are just like Jesus. How does this work? If the Holy Spirit isn't convicting me of my sin, how do I live? If I'm no longer bound by the Ten Commandments and all the other rules, how do I live? How do I know what to do if I'm not being told what to do? It's because the Holy Spirit convicts you of your righteousness. That word convict is to completely convince, to remind you of again and again and again until you just accept it. So here's how it goes. Whether you're dabbling in sin or whether you're already fully into sin or whether you're in sin up to your eyeballs, the Holy Spirit comes along and says, son, this isn't who you are. You're holy. Son, you're pure. I know you're still using foul language, but you're pure. If you believed you're pure, you wouldn't let filth come out of your lips because your purity would cancel it. That's not who you are. He convicts you of your righteousness. He says, no, you don't need to run away from me because we're good. We're solid. You can come to me and get filled up so that you can go out and spread. So the moment you find yourself about to commit that sin again, the Lord whispers in your ear. He's not going to shout. He's going to whisper. And he'll say, my beloved child, I love you so much. This isn't you. You're just like me. I've made you just like me. And what I would like you to do is take $20 and go give it to her and tell her that it wasn't her fault. Tell her that I love her. I was there the day that thing happened when she was 13. I was holding her hand as it occurred. I've been with her ever since. I love her, and I want to make her mine. Will you go tell her? And you're over here about to smoke, drink, whatever it is you're going to do, and suddenly the Holy Spirit convicts you of your righteousness. You walk away from that, and you go do Jesus stuff. Because he's speaking to you all the time. He loves you like you can't even begin to imagine. He's convicting you of your righteousness every moment, reminding you who he has made you to be. He's commissioned you and called you to go lead Jesus' life as a brand new lifestyle, as a brand new way of living, as a brand new mode of existence that will so overshadow the stuff that you were doing before that you'll never want to turn back. That you will just grab this and you will run forward with all that you are. Amen?
Amen.
Will you stand to your feet? Did I go too long, Mark?
We have lunch.
We have lunch?
Maybe
today you are a verse 9 person who, like Michael was earlier, you are an unbeliever. Holy Spirit convicts you of your need to believe. And you just want to do that right now. You just want to confess that Jesus Christ is your King. You want to confess that he is your Savior. You want to be reborn into his kingdom so he can convict you of your righteousness and commission you to go do his stuff for the rest of your life. If that's you today and you need to be saved or you want to be saved, your moment is coming up. I'm going to ask you in just a second to step out on the aisle and come down front. And we're going to pray a simple prayer with you and you'll be saved. And you will become just as righteous as Jesus, just as perfect as Jesus, just as pure as Jesus, just as holy as Jesus. And everything that's true of him is true of you. You'll have the same relationship with the Father. You'll have his commission to go into the world and do his stuff. If that's you this morning and you'd like to be saved, just come right on down here. It'll only take you a moment, and we're going to get you out to lunch. Right on down front. Everybody here saved. Mark, you've done a great job. Everybody here saved. Okay, let's do this then. If you're being convicted of your righteousness and you want to be continually, ongoingly, permanently convicted of your righteousness, this altar call is for you. And we're going to pray over you that you would receive that and he would seal that in you. That it would help you to dampen all the noise of life and let you focus on his voice so he can convict you of your righteousness. He can convict you of his love for you. He can convict you of his holiness within you. He can convict you of his commission upon you. He can convict you of your perfection and your purity, of his peace. Presence within them, you're calling upon them, your holiness, your righteousness, your power, your authority, overcoming every issue, complete freedom. complete freedom. The Spirit of truth sets you free. Complete freedom. I declare over you complete freedom right now in Jesus' name. Perfection. Purity. He says over you, purity. He says over you, purity. You are pure. He says you are purity. I wish
there
you
is
see
no
the way he sees
other
you.
Name
he is declaring you are
Jesus.
Pure. He will not let anyone or anything.
There
or
is no other
pure.
Name.
I don't know what that means for you, but he says it's important.
There is no other
His
name.
That word holiness means wholeness, nothing lacking, nothing missing,
he
nothing
is
broken.
He is
I declare it over each of you, over all
love.
Of you, over this entire house, over this entire
no
room. I declare this over your leader, over your shepherd, over your pastor.
There is no
Father, I just thank you so much. Oh, what a shender came in, but I say no sondo came in, but I shan't.
There is no
Pastor Mark, I speak strength in you.
He is
the strength of God.
Is
the strength of God. The wisdom to guide these his stubborn people.
Your voice
strength to endure, to move on, to go forward, to take this vision and grow it and expand it. To minister to everyone that even put places in your care. Oh, that came.
Hallelujah. Good word. Thank you, Douglas. Good word. Give him a hand. Amen. Appreciate that. Amen. I want you to know if there's anything the enemy wants to fight more than anything else in your life is you understanding who you are now that you're a Christian. Simple but true. Enemy doesn't want you to realize who you are in Christ. He'd rather you just be worried about. Yes, amen. Speak to him. Yes. Amen.
Because everywhere you go, you bring the presence of God. In every situation you enter into, the very presence of God shows up. When Moses and Joshua would go into a battle, he would say, I am with you. And when he was with them, they cannot lose. And Jesus says, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. You cannot lose. Every situation you step into, he's giving you. Every place you set your foot, he's given to you. And he says, even when it looks like a setback, it's a set up, because I'm going to bring you out even better than it was before you had not gone into that.
Amen.
Powerful.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Amen. I understand. The weather's a little nicer down there. Yeah, she's pretty good. Amen. Let's do this. Everybody grab hands together. We're going to pray. We're going to pray for lunch, too. I'm really, really excited that all of you came down front like this. Hallelujah. Bow your heads with me. Father, we thank you, oh God, that your heart's desire for us is to realize so much what salvation means and what it means for us to walk in you and you in us. Help us to realize, Father God, that we are free to be who you've made us in. We thank you for this wonderful word this morning. We ask you to bless our fellowship and our meal together this afternoon. Bless your people. Let them have a hilarious week. Let them be filled with the Spirit this week and just walk each day. World changers and life changers in Jesus' name. We thank you for that. And everybody said amen.
Amen.
Bless you guys. We'd like to get the older folks in line first. So
if
Douglas and Heather are welcome to go first, and then all the older folks, so like me and Bob. I'm ancient, Donald. Amen. Amen. We do pray for safe travels for thee. Which lane?
I go last usually.
If I told you my story, you would hear hope. They wouldn't let go. If I told you my story, you would hear love that never gave up. And if I told